Hello, my name is Dr. Julian Wanjira Oshira, and I am most Kenyan. So I'm really happy to be doing this video. Because it's actually my first video since I left med school, which was like 2 weeks ago, and I'm really happy about it because med school can be quite unpredictable. So I'm really interested in health, and working as a doctor is going to be exciting for me. So today, I want to talk about health and what I have understood so far about it and what I aspire to do as a doctor, and hopefully inspire you also to take care of your health because it has the best benefit for you in your life. So according to the definitions, the different definitions of health that are there, health is the complete well-being of someone, not just a lack of physical illness. So you take care of your mental health, you take care of your social well-being, and you take care of physical well-being. And that way, when you're wholesome, that's when you say you're healthy. So we don't only look at your physical well-being, because you can have someone who is dealing with an illness and they're healthier. Physically, they're not as healthy, but they're healthier all round if they have taken care of their mental well-being and their social well-being. So I'll start talking about social well-being, and it's interesting because there's a study that has been done by Harvard. It's a pretty common and famous study. If you can check online, it's about the predictors of health. And so they followed up men from college, some guys from college, all the way through their lives, all the way to their 90s and 80s and to their death. And they wanted to find out how healthy these people were and what were the determinants of their health. Was it physical exercise, or was it their mental well-being, or their social well-being? And interesting enough, they found that the most fundamental or key determinant of their health or their complete well-being was their social interactions. That is, the men who had good relationships, they had a good social network, had a better health at the end of it. At their 50s, in their 60s, in their 70s, they had less illnesses, they were well, their mental well-being was good, they had good families. And this is interesting because for me, for a long time, I thought physical well-being is the main determinant of the main determinant of health. So that was interesting, because if you look at our society, our African society is majorly based on, we are a community-based, you know, society. And most of the time, I don't know if that's taken as a positive or a negative, but if you look at it at the end of it now, it looks like it's a positive. And for social well-being, that means it plays a key role in your physical well-being and your mental well-being. So your friends really matter, and your relationships and how happy you are with them also is a key determinant. And if you look at our society, in terms of social transformation, once you are healthy, then that means the people around, you'll be happier, you'll feel more fulfilled when you're close to family and friends and people you care about, you'll be happier. So that means even your physical well-being will be better, and at the end of it, you'll treat people better and our societies will be better. So towards social transformation, I still do believe that health is key. Having a healthy population, having people who are aware of their health and their well-being. And I hope that you, from today, or if I hope you have been taking care of your health and you'll continue. Most people have talked about that, you know, we have gyms and we have healthy eating and all. You just figure out what works for you. It's usually said exercise is not a remedy for the foods that you actually just overeat and then now you go for exercise. No, there has to be a balance. There's some people who say, you know, I'll eat healthy and not exercise, and some people say I'll exercise and then eat all I can. There has to be a balance. You eat healthy, sometimes of course you have cheat days, but you also have to exercise because you have to build the muscle. Even if you eat right, your muscles need that, and that strength that comes from physical exercise. So maybe you can actually also figure out what works for you physically. I believe social transformation begins with you and figuring out what pumps you and what makes you feel alive, and you know, and pursuing that and being able to contribute to the community and the society through that. If you're good at finances, if you're good at health, if you're good at, you know, athletics, just pursuing what really gets you going. And that way we have a society with people who are working and giving their best in their different fields. So as a doctor, I hope to be in the front line to encourage the people that I treat or I meet to be able to practice health seeking behaviors that can keep them away from hospital and that can make them have an optimized life through having a good health. So I hope to interact with my patients, not only in the curative side, but in the preventive side, by educating them on telling them, you know, this is what you can do to avoid this kind of thing, and this is what you can do, or this is what is not advised. And I have a website that I've already started writing. It's Health Hub Kenya. You can check it out. And I hope to grow it and make it something that can actually help Kenyans live a better life through optimized health. Thank you for listening to this video. I am happy to be on this forum and I approve this message. So, bye.